Good morning, everybody. Does this look familiar? Has life been trading you lemons recently? If so, tune in. I'm going to talk to you today about the lemons in your life. I'm going to ask some questions and see if any of these questions resonate with you. Has your stress level been skyrocketing lately? Or perhaps you've lost a job, started a new job? Are you going through the aftermath of a difficult divorce or a separation? Or perhaps you're a newlywed and you're super overwhelmed. Could it be health issues that you're struggling with? Perhaps financial difficulties or even workplace challenges, be it a difficult boss or, you know, uncooperative team. So if you're going through any of these life-changing events here, I would like to acknowledge you. And I'd like to tell you that the struggle is real. So yes, I feel you and I hear you. And I know very well that you are going through this emotionally and mentally and perhaps physically as well. Now, this is actually a model that explains what we go through during change, and it's called the grief cycle. Now, it has another name, which is the roller coaster, and I identify more with that name. So let me take you through this so you can better understand what's going on within, on the inside. So moving from here, let's have a look at this amazing model that really makes us feel normal, that what we're going through is real. So as you can see here, we have two axes. Now the x-axis is basically time, and the y-axis here is the intensity of the emotion. So when you go up, this is an outward active emotion that we show to the world. And when you go down, you see a more inwards kind of emotion or a passive emotion that we suffer from on the inside. So let me take you through what happens to us, this roller coaster that you can see on my screen here. So we're stable, life is good, everything is fine, and then the lemons hit us. One of those drastic changes happen. And the first reaction is complete shock. Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening. So shock. And that's a passive emotion, as you can see. And then after a while, you're like, no, that's not happening to me. It can be me. So let's take an example of divorce, for example, or separation. Oh my God, my husband or my wife or partner, they can't have left me. Not after all these years. I cannot believe it. So you are in a denial state. They're going to come back. This can't be happening. Okay? Or losing a job, whatever it is that you're in, you know, relevant to the question that I asked you at the beginning. And then what happens next when, like, the harsh reality hits you, you're like, okay, it is real, but I do not accept it. I'm angry, I am mad at everything, and you start lashing out at everyone and everything. And then after that, you go to the following stage, which is more of the bargaining stage. And this is where you start your trade-offs. Okay, if you do this for me, I'm willing to come back and do that for you. So you try everything and anything, but then again, the harsh realities hit you and you're like, oh my God, this has changed forever. This is real. So you start going down here. You see, it's kind of peaks and troughs. So you fall into depression. And this is the complete sadness, shutting down, isolation, and you name it. Now, after a while, if you have grit and resilience, and this is coming now, you will be able to pull yourself out of this black hole and kind of move to a more positive stage, which is the testing stage. Okay, let's play with this. Let's see if it works for me. Maybe I am better off, you know, alone. This relationship was toxic, or this job was not really unleashing my potential, and now there is endless possibilities. So you start thinking positively and you try out the new situation. Now, if this works for you, then eventually you reach the acceptance stage and you integrate the new change and move forward. That that's, of course, ideally. Now, I know that you guys must be thinking, how long does it take us to navigate the roller coaster? And that's actually a clever question. And I would like for you to share in the comments, how long do you think it takes to navigate this curve? So that's exactly where I kick in as your coach. I can help you develop the meta skill of the 21st century, grit. So let's see what grit means exactly. So grit is a mindset and a skill set as well. And I love this acronym that I'm sharing with you here on the screen. And if we look at it, it has different components because a lot of people kind of mix it up with perseverance or even persistence. But actually, this is one component. So let's see what it means. So G is growth, having the growth mentality, being creative, seeking feedback, seeking self-development and growth, believing in yourself, being a do-check person, and always seeking continuous improvement. So that's the G factor. And then we move on to the R factor, which is the resilience. And when we talk about resilience, it's your ability to bounce back when you're faced with setbacks or when you're faced with adversity. So, and here I would love to share a quote. I really love that quote. So your setback might be your setup for your comeback. And that's exactly part of what having grit is about. And then we move on to the I, and I is the instinctual knowing. It's that inherent built-in campus. It's your intuition that tells you what is really the best course of action or the best path for your life journey. And then finally, we move on to tenacity, which is a combination of perseverance and persistence. And this is how hard and how much you try to achieve your goals. So all these combined gives you the element of growth, gives you the element of never giving in or giving up, and also propels you forward. And that's the difference between resilience and grit. Book your free 20-minute session to explore how, as your coach, I could support you develop your grit to create this whole field of lemons. Have an amazing day.